Hello, this is Umer Ali. I am from Malik. I am from biotechnology. In this video, I will teach about molecular cloning vector. If you wanted to get video lecture, video notes, and different notes, scholarship updates, and wanted to know the information regarding admission in top rank universities, log on to my website umaraliBTH.com and subscribe or follow my blog. So in this video we will talk about the molecular cloning vectors. What are the cloning vectors? These are the DNA molecules that carry a foreign DNA fragment when inserted into each. What should be the characteristics of a cloning vector? It has ability to replicate autonomously. It contains genetic marker for selection, unique restriction site for the filtration of cloning of DNA of insert, and minimum amount of non-essential DNA to optimal cloning. What are the different types of cloning vectors? Plasmid, number one, phages, number two, hybrid vector, number three, and artificial chromosome. What are plasmids? These are the extra chromosome self-replicating double-stranded closed circular DNA in bacteria. They have high and low copy number. They are small in size. The gene limit, there is no limit of genes. They also have episomes. In this picture, you are seeing different characteristics of a cloning vector. This is a plasmid clone. It has ampicillin resistance gene. It has origin of replication and multiple cloning sites. So who first used plasmid as a gene cloning vector? Chang and Cohen first proved the use of plasmid as a gene cloning vector. What are the characteristics of plasmid vectors? They are small in size, 1.2 to 3 kilobases. Copy number is mostly high and low. Genetic markers, they show genetic marker for their selection. They also have origin of replication. They show unique restriction site for different restriction endemic species. They do not show pathogenicity. They have multiple cloning sites and they also show promoter sequence. These are some of the polylinkers for sites for restriction endemic species and origin of replication shown in this diagram. Okay. What is the basic difference between natural and artificial plasmid? Plasmids that are isolated from bacteria directly and used for gene cloning are called as natural plasmid, but we do not use gene cloning during large size confined to the pathogenicity. Mostly the artificial or derived plasmid that we have constructed by cutting out unwanted portions from wild type bacteria are called as artificial. We can take an example as TB or C22. They are used much wider as compared to the natural plasmid. What are the advantages and disadvantages? They are readily isolated from cell, can be reintroduced in the bacterial cell as they are part of the bacteria. They possess a single restriction size for one or more restriction sites. They show multiple cloning sites. The introduction of linear molecule does not alter its replication. What are the disadvantages? They do not accept large. Now we talk about lambda phage vector. Lambda phage is a bacterial virus that infects E. coli. It consists of a cursor, has a head and flexible phage. Phage DNA type inside the head, lambda DNA, the linear DNA replaces with cohesive single strand tension. The single strand section of DNA are complementary to each other and consist of 12 nucleotide carbide. Free end of the carbide has a 5 prime phosphate group. Okay, this is the diagram of lambda phage. You can see head, tail, and different other carbide and other tail in head genes of lambda phage vector. Lambda phage DNA carries large DNA fragment and integrate into host chromosome. Wild type lambda DNA can carry only small fragment. The unwanted sequence are cut out and constructed lambda DNA vector. It is a two-type insertion vector which show restriction site fragment upright interlobe replacement vector to restriction site, removal of tuple sequence. Okay. Advantages and disadvantages. Large DNA fragment up to 23 kilobase can be carried. Efficiency of gene transfer is high, but the combination of DNA may enter lytic cycle, which is a very serious disadvantage. Number of has a narrow host range. It can only be applicated to specific strains. Okay. M13, the carrier phage vector, single stranded DNA containing phage virus can infect a positive cell. Consists of about 6,000. It consists of 6,404 base pairs. The intergenic sequence IS of M13 modified to introduce addition restriction site so that vast variety of endemic diseases can act on it. The lack that can be integrated into it and used to get M13 as a vector. Okay, hybrid vector cosmid and admit. Okay. Artificial plasmid containing core sites of lambda DNA are called cosmids. They are formed by joining end of DNA plasmid with core sites as a region of replication flexible marker cloning site of plasmid DNA. Feature of cosmid, it is circular double stranded DNA molecule to complement the single stranded region. Core sites are attached. What are the features of cosmid? Circular double stranded DNA to complement the single stranded region and cosmid. Cosmid DNA do not code for phage protein and host cell lysis, does not involve in multiplication of phage particles as an origin from plasmid for independent replication, has left lexical marker genome gene cloning side of plasmid DNA. Advantage is large DNA fragment. Used to establish gene libraries of lower and higher organisms. Gene cloning through cosmid helps in the study of nonsense sequencing genome of organisms. Further, disadvantages the packaging enzyme failed to pack the recombinant cosmid into feed bed if one of the cause sites is missing. Phagemid. There are also called as phagemid. Hybrid vector that has origin of application from the plasmid and lambda phage DNA is constructed by setting a linearized plasmid DNA into cleaved lambda DNA. It can be used to maintain the plasmid or phage particle in nuclear. The desired gene can be integrated into chromosomal DNA of nuclear using phagemid. Plasmid portion can be released free from phagemid after recombinant phagemid is introduced in the bloodstream, the phage having recombinant phagemid can be stored easily for long term. What are the artificial chromosomes? Mostly used artificial chromosomes called gametes. What are they? Produce cloning vehicle that can propagate in eukaryotic cell. Host as a eukaryotic chromosome, they can clone very large fragments from 100 kb to 10 and be of size. They are cloning vehicle for plasmid. Final chimeric DNA is linear DNA molecule with telomeric ends are called artificial chromosomes. You can see in the diagram the different characteristics of Jack often have resting for an insert. Jack cloning vehicle often have a region of DNA replication ovary and flexion marker for propagation of VHP to failure. Use both bacteria and yeast as a host. Back and tag. Back are bacterial artificial chromosomes. They are primary DNA molecule having low copy number. It is plasmid origin of replication vector. It is next plasmid nucleus. It can be cloned as a plasmid and bacterial host. As compared to the tag, tags are T1 derived artificial chromosomes. E. coli bacteria phage T1 is similar to the phagemid lambda in that it can exist in nuclei in a prophage state. Existing nuclei shall have a plasmid not integrated in nuclear chromosome. T1 cloning vehicle has been constructing that permits cloning of large DNA at 300 kb of DNA. Cloning of propagation of the chimeric DNA is T1 cloning vehicle set. Because this is the diagrammatic difference between Jack and Tag. You can see easily they have original replication, they
That one, they have insulin resistance, clear fat, 34% and low waist capacity. Okay. Other human artificial chromosome has, they can be synthetically produced after DNA processing, the characteristics of human chromosome, they are discovered in 1997 by a believer. What are they going to? They can carry human gene, they can gene, they can be used to produce them into human. Definition, the expression vector. What are expression vector? They are also called an expression construct. They are plasmid or virus designed for the production of protein, production of gene by the expression of protein in host cell. Expression vectors are mostly expression signals such as strong promoter, termination signal, codon, adjustment of distance between promoter and clone gene, and insertion of transcription termination sequence as a portable translation initiation sequence. Expression vectors are used for molecular biology techniques such as high-stress mutagenesis. Once the expression vector inside cell are released to protein that are encoded by genes produced by the cellular transcription and translation between the ribosomal complex. The plasmid is frequently engineered to contain regulatory sequence that occur in the enter and promoter region and lead to efficient transcription of gene carried to the expression vector. The goal of well-designed expression vector is the production of large amount of stable mRNA and in extension the production of proteins. They are the basic rule of biotechnology for the production of large amount of protein. After expression of gene product, the purification of protein is required. Okay, but for the purification we can use the histidine tag etc. so that we can easily purify our clone gene so that we can purify the protein. What are the prokaryotic expression vectors? They have promoter commonly used, inducible promoter derived from black opron and T-central promoter. They are called as strong promoter, tryptophan or trip opron, tag promoter, a hybrid collection of both trip and black opron called as TRET. Ribosomal bonding site called as RBS follows the promoter. Promoter assists in translation of the protein of interest. Translation and initiation site called as Delgarno sequence enclosing ribosomal binding site 8 base pair upstream of AUG start codon. The basic requirement for any expression system is the promoter cloning site. Next is transcriptional termination so that it can help origin suitable for application initiation in a particular bacteria or any host. A select marker genes such as antibiotic resistance gene regulator element signed Delgado. This is the diagram. What a lack that expression vector. Lack that promoter better than the same with lack that alpha fragment from the amino terminal of lactosidase gene. It has multiple chronic signs found in the border of the amino and including ATG sequence. The presence of such site help to functionality of the protein which complement the omega fragment of the lag that produced by bacterial cell as well as supplement. If gene is placed in proper frame in the MCS, the protein stress will be fused form. The expression of the gene can be regulated by IPTG, isopropylthiobeta-glycosidase. PET expression vectors, they have 550, 700 base pairs, they have T7 promoter and adjacent to the black operator. Their next split sequence called as Sandelgarmo sequence, they expression in the tRNA polymerase which is under the control of black base operator. The repressor produced by the bacterial like IT can be reduced by IPTG. Other type of vector, subtle vector integration, transposon, retroviruses, adenoviruses, and baculoviruses. So, conclusion, there are different type of cloning vector using genetic engineering. They include plasmid, phagemid, hybrid vectors, artificial chromosome. The best vector is chosen for use according to the purpose of use and according to how large, short, the DNA fragment
So guys, if you like my video, kindly subscribe to my channel and log to my website umerali.com. Kindly like the video, share the video and subscribe to my channel.